Hello everyone and good afternoon and welcome to the next part of Cockroach, that is part 2. I hope all are fine and have revised what we did yesterday. So before I begin today's lecture, as I told you all last time also, next zoology lecture we will have a test on all the zoology topics covered till now. Okay, so there will be a live test. So what I'll do, I'll display some questions on the board, okay, say 10 questions or 5 questions at one time, and I'll give you all time to write the answers, fine, and then we will discuss those questions, then I'll go to the next slide, then I'll have again 10 questions, clear? So now this is the way y'all can test yourself also, how much y'all are understanding, how much y'all are scoring, theek hai? And y'all have to be quick and right at the same time. So I hope everyone is clear with it. Okay, so go through your AI coach of all zoology chapters, whatever we have done till date. Go through all the questions present in the AI coach. And if you all have any other books, go through it. Take this opportunity to complete these chapters 100%. So that after this test, you all will be like, done. Now there is no need for me to revise these chapters. Explanation ho gaya, AI coach is done, test is done. Am I clear? So this is what I have planned. You all have lot of time for it because from next week there will be botany for 2 or 3 weeks. After that we will have zoology. And then after that test, only one lecture I'll give for test, that is 1 hour. How many ever questions we can solve, that will be great. It is not a limit. 1 hour mein I will prepare many questions and come. Now it depends on your speed, how many questions we can do. Clear? Then we will start with human physiology, the next lecture. Am I clear? So any doubt in cockroach part in what we did yesterday? Come on. Anything? Hello everyone. Yes, Saloni, you'll have a lot of time to prepare for it. Don't worry. No doubt in yesterday's part? Okay, chalo, let's start with today's lecture. There are many things to do in today's lecture. Let's begin. So yesterday we spoke about head and thorax. Today we are talking about abdomen. Don't go in details of abdomen. Just refer to this chart what I have mentioned here. Okay, as we know that abdomen is also having the sclerites. Total, there are 10 segments. But when I talk about male cockroach and female cockroach, there are certain differences seen. What is it? First thing, males show presence of 10 terja. What is terja? Tergite or tergum, which is on dorsal side. Dorsal meaning above. 10 terja. Females also have 10 terja. Similar. But still there is a difference. What is the difference? The 10th terja, in that the 7th terja covers the 8th. But in female, out of 10, the 7th covers 8th and 9th. So that means if I am drawing a male cockroach, this will be the thorax part, so abdomen will be this. I will see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 is very much attached to it. This will be in males. But what about in females? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 is attached to 8 and 9. So 7, 8, 9 will be fused here. Somewhat very closer. That is the difference. So here 7th covers the 8th, but here 7th covers 8th and 9th. This is about terja. These points are about the dorsal surface. When I talk about the ventral surface, even that is different in males and female. In this, in males and in female, total 9 sterna are seen. Okay? And out of this 9 in males, or the 9 are completely visible. But in females, the 7 sterna are seen, which covers 8th and 9th. Similar to that seen in terja. Clear? So that means if there is a female body this way, or if you see the ventral side. In both the cases, 7th is covering 8th and 9th. Clear? Now, in both the cases, males and females, there are 10 terja and 9 sterna. What is terja? This is the body of this is the body that is a dorsal. Let it be male or female. There are 10 terjas. Am I clear with it? 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th. The 10th terja is a larger one. How is it? This is the 10th terja. It is covering it on the ventral side also. 10th terja is covering it. So that means when I see the ventral side of cockroach, there is no space for 10th sterna. Hence only 9 sterna are visible. Am I clear with this? Hence it is written that 10 terja is large and projects backwards. Backwards meaning down. Am I clear with this? Is this chart clear? Come on, I want you all to keep on messaging yes or no, because there are many difficult terms here. Yes, students, is the terja and sterna part clear? Okay, so this is about the terja and sterna. Fine? So I hope this point is clear. Apart from that, nothing else is needed in the abdomen. Theek hai? So abdomen, if questions will be asked, 4 statements will be given and they'll say true and false. So there are so many statements where they can confuse you all. Theek hai? With this, we complete the head, thorax and abdomen part. Fine? Now, the next part, if you all remember, is the appendages arising from abdomen. If you all remember, we had it in thorax also. What were the appendages arising from thorax? It was the wings and legs. Similarly, we also have certain appendages. Appendages meaning extensions arising from abdomen as well. This is only the abdomen part which is shown. What are those? The first type of appendages is anal cerci. What is anal cerci? This is anal. Anal meaning the tail part. It is something which is seen in both the sexes. This is the male and the female. Don't worry about the internal part. That is about reproductive system. We will see it later. Fine. In this, we have the anal cerci which is arising from 10th terja. That means on the dorsal side. If you all can see the difference in the two diagram, this is the difference. This part is not there in female, but this part is similar in both. So these are the anal cerci. It appears as if it is a leg, but it is not a leg. Legs arise from thorax. These are the anal cerci. What is the function of this anal cerci? These are sensitive to touch and sound. Okay. If you are standing beside a cockroach, if just a shadow or something, if your foot touches the cockroach is able to sense it. Or if it is a loud sound, the cockroach is able to sense it. Because of anal cerci. Clear? Next is anal style. Very, very, very important question. Anal styles are seen only in males. Right? Why? Because this is additional area for sensitivity. That is sensitivity to touch only. So in males, there are two types of receptors for touch, style and cerci. But in female, it is only cerci. Cerci is for sound and touch both. Am I clear? So that means if we clearly look at the male and female body externally, we can easily come to know whether it is a male cockroach or a female. This is sexual dimorphism. If you all remember yesterday's first slide in the cockroach, this is external feature by which we can understand whether it is a male cockroach or a female cockroach. Am I clear? Apart from that, there are certain gonapophyces also which are seen. What are these gonapophyses? If you all can see these extensions, what are these extensions? If this is the abdomen, there are some extensions present here which is considered to be external genitalia. These are the gonapophyses. Don't worry about gonapophyses, we'll study in the reproductive system. Fine. So this is about the abdominal appendages. Any question? So is the abdomen part clear? Yes or no? Okay, Saloni, great. Shruti, I have not given any timing, dear. Don't worry, it will be after 2 weeks. Great, Saloni. What about others? Yes or no? Perfect, perfect. Okay, so with this we complete the morphological part. Now we will start with the systems. Different systems are there obviously in cockroaches also. I will be giving you all certain flowcharts about each system. Do that much only, more than enough. Okay, so I'll start with the reproductive system first because that is something which is difficult. Baki all is very easy. So let's start with the reproductive system. Very different type of reproductive system is there in cockroach and earthworm. So let's see what is cockroach. So I'll start with male reproductive system. This is the male reproductive system. Okay. This is the cut section of a male reproductive system, which is this part. This is the abdominal part, right? The thorax and head ko cut, it is not seen in the diagram. So definitely one thing is clear, that entire reproductive system is in the abdominal part. Fine. What all things can you see? The abdomen, the one sec. Yeah. So let's see the parts. The male reproductive system consists of, number one, a pair of testes. This is second. So there is a pair of testes. These are two in number, but if you see, each testes has three lobes. This is one, two, and three, and this is the three lobes here. First, second, third. So two testes, one testes has three lobes. Obviously, what is the function of testes? The testes produce sperms. Clear? First thing. So this is the first part. One more thing about testes we have to remember. Here in males, the testes are directly embedded in the fat layer or fat tissue. Clear? This is the first part. Let's go to the second. The testes are producing sperms. So definitely there has to be a sperm duct to pass those sperms. What is it? Same as it is in us. That is in humans, that is vasa deferentia. These are the vasa deferentias, which is acting like sperm duct. Again, one pair. Next is the third part, that is ejaculatory duct. It is there in humans also, right? The two vasa deferentia combine and form ejaculatory duct. In humans, vasa deferentia combines with the duct of seminal vesicle to form ejaculatory duct, if you all remember. Here, it is directly ejaculatory duct which is formed because of vasa deferentia. So, this is ejaculatory duct. it is one ejaculatory duct with two chambers, and these ejaculatory ducts are opening directly outside. Clear? So this is the third part. Fine. At the junction of vasa deferens and ejaculatory duct, there is a gland which is present. This one. This is known as mushroom glands. Okay? Or it is utricular gland. Am I clear? So at the junction of vasa deferens and ejaculatory, there is this mushroom gland. If you can see, it is a big gland. Okay, what is the function of it? I'll come to it later. Behind this mushroom gland, there is one more gland which is seen. This is phallic gland. Okay, and at the lower part, we can see external genitalia, that is the opening. Now, what are these external genitalia? This is the extensions of the external genitalia, which is known as phallomeres. These are extensions coming out from the end part in the male cockroaches. So there is a left phallomere. There is a pseudo penis also, which is seen, which is acting like right phallomere. Am I clear with this? Any question in the structures first? Yes or no, students? Tell me. Perfect, Sushmita. What about others? Okay, so this is about the male reproductive system. So what all things are there? We have a pair of testes. We have vasa differentia arising from those. Those vasa differentia fuse and form the ejaculatory duct. At the junction, there is this mushroom gland. Behind mushroom, there is this phallic gland. At the end, there are the external genitalia in the form of extensions known as phallomere. Clear? This is about the main parts of male reproductive system. Fine. Now, before going ahead, let's talk about mushroom gland here. Now, if I just draw to explain y'all, I'll just rub this and explain it here only. The mushroom gland consists of three parts. There are large tubules, small tubules, and seminal vesicle. These are the three parts of mushroom. The large tubules, meaning what? If I just draw a representation, these are large tubules forming the periphery of the mushroom gland. Large tubules. Second thing is the small tubules. These are the small tubules. And in between that small tubules, I will have seminal vesicle. This is one mushroom gland. Clear? Now, this mushroom gland is playing a very important role in the, letting out sperms from the body. How? First thing, what will be the function of seminal vesicle? Same, for storage of sperms. What about large and small tubule? Large and small tubules help in the formation of spermatophore. This is something which is very different in cockroaches. It is not in humans. What is it? Now, in humans, the sperms are directly released, right? It is released in the form of seminal fluid, that is ejaculatory fluid, either outside or in the female's body. We know it. But in cockroaches, the sperms are released in small packets. So many sperms, they form a packet. They form a bundle. They form a sac. that is known as spermatophore. Clear? This spermatophore is not present inside the male reproductive system. It forms when the sperms are collected. Okay, so sperms are getting formed. As they come in this mushroom gland, the spermatophore gets formed. It is a cover which is formed around a bundle of sperms. How is it formed? I'll come to it in some time. Am I clear? So this is the main function of mushroom gland, helping in that spermatophore formation. Along with the mushroom, even the phallic gland helps in this formation. How? When? Why? I'll come to it in 2 minutes. Am I clear with this? So this is the most important part of mushroom. Fine. Along with that, the large tubules of the mushroom shows presence of certain uricose gland. The word itself says uricose means it releases uric acid, which is an excretory product, nitrogenous waste. So that means in male cockroaches, the male reproductive system has an excretory organ. Am I clear? This is about the basis of a male reproductive system. Clear? Now I'll go to the process of sperm release. Am I clear with this? Any question? Yes or no? Students, pay attention to these part because it's given confusing in NCERT. So I'm trying to make it very clear for you all and very easier. Perfect, Saloni. Perfect, Shmita. What about others? Why only 2 people are saying yes, no, anything? What about others? Where are y'all? Okay, so what questions are expected from this slide, whatever I've mentioned? They can ask ejaculatory duct, how is it formed? By fusion of only vasa differentia. They can ask what is mushroom gland and what are its parts? The 3 parts are large tubule, small tubule, seminal vesicle. They can ask what is the function of phallic gland. Phallic gland and mushroom gland help in the formation of spermatophore, which is like a sac. Clear? That's it. Nothing else is expected from here. If you have taken the screenshot or not, come on, take it. I'll go to the next slide then. Great. Chalo, next. Next is about the mushroom gland. This is what I was saying. It consists of 3 parts. That is the large tubules, which have uricose gland, small tubules and seminal vesicle. Clear? So you all can take a screenshot of this. I've already explained this. Okay. Now let's go to the formation of how is the sperms discharged. Clear? Okay. Okay, do one thing. I'll just explain it in the diagram only. I'll explain it here how the sperms are released. Then you all can see that the screenshot. I have given properly the flow chart, so don't write anything, just listen. How much ever you all can grasp today, that will be better. Don't waste your time much in doing these parts. Just refer to the diagrams given by me and the flow charts given by me. Don't go in detail. I've tried to cover everything through the flowcharts. I love studying by flowcharts, remember that, and that will be very helpful for your medical also. We don't have time to read so much of, you know, content. Make small flowcharts and done. Your job is done. Come on, let's talk about sperms. So definitely the sperms will be formed here in the testes. The sperms will be released via vasa differentia After this, the sperms enter this mushroom gland. Where will it enter? It will enter the seminal vesicle because that is for storage. Okay. So now the sperms have entered the seminal vesicles. Now what happens? Once they are released in the seminal vesicles, here the spermatophore formation begins. How? Sabse pehle, the large tubules of mushroom gland will secrete a layer. Okay, so suppose these are the sperms. These are the sperms. The large tubules will secrete a secretion. This secretion will form the first layer around the sperms. First layer of spermatophore. This is the inner layer of spermatophore. Okay? At the same time, small tubules will also release a secretion, not to form a layer, but for nourishment of the sperms. Obviously, they require nourishment. So, large tubule se secretion aya, it formed first layer. Small tubule se secretion aya, it is giving nourishment. Clear? Now, what happens? After this, there is a secretion coming from ejaculatory duct also. This forms a second layer around the inner one. That is the middle layer. Who is forming the middle layer? The ejaculatory duct. And at the end, the secretions come from phallic gland. And this forms the outer layer. Okay, so three layers are formed. This full structure is spermatophore. Such many packets are formed. All these packets come from ejaculatory duct and they are released. Either they will be released outside or they will be released into the female tract. Clear? This is how the sperms are released. Fine? So now I guess you all can see the flow chart what I have written. So this is about the sperm release. Obviously the sperms are produced in the testes, then they reach the vasa deferens. Then they are stored in the seminal vesicle. In the seminal vesicle, the large tubule will form the first layer. Small tubule will form nourishment. Then the spermatophore thickens because of ejaculatory and phallic. Ejaculatory is forming the middle layer. Phallic is forming the outer. Then the sperms are released by phallomeres in the form of spermatophore. I hope this flowchart is easier for you all to remember. The major mistake what students make is they give three options or you know A, B, C and they ask what is the layer formed and who is forming the layer. Students write even small tubule is forming a layer. No. Small tubules do not form any layer of spermatophore. Clear? This is about the male reproductive. Done everyone? Take the screenshot. Am I clear with this? Any question in the male reproductive part or should I go ahead? Okay, great. Now let's go to the female reproductive part. This is the female reproductive part. Again, very unique. Let's see. So what are the parts in the female reproductive system? A pair of ovaries. Definitely. Again, the ovaries are directly embedded in the fat. If you can see in this ovaries, there are certain designs which are made. Right? These designs are known as ovarioles. And within this ovarioles, the egg will be formed. So egg is formed here. it comes down and it gets mature. So by the time it reaches here, it is ready to come out. So these are the ovaries in which maturation of the egg or the ova take place. Both the ovaries are there. It has to be an oviduct. These are the oviduct. Fine. The two oviducts combine and form common oviduct, or it is known as vagina. So this is a difference here. Right? The oviduct is directly forming vagina, no uterus and all. Why? Because there is no implantation happening. It is egg, oviparous. Clear? This is about the vagina. So vagina can be called as common oviduct, or I can simply call it vagina. After vagina, there is a genital pouch. So this part is the genital pouch. Pouch means what? A space. Now let's understand what is this genital pouch. 1 minute. This is the layer or the wall of genital pouch. Theek hai? So what was above? We had ovaries, oviduct, vagina. This entire area is the genital pouch. If you can see, this area is the genital pouch. I hope you all are understanding what is the meaning of genital pouch. Right? This genital pouch has two openings. There is an opening ahead, anterior and posterior. Pay attention to this. Clear? So this genital pouch has two openings. Theek hai? One opening will open into genital chamber. This is anterior or the front chamber. Am I clear? The posterior opening is opening into vestibulum or uthecal chamber. Am I clear with this? So the wall or the roof of genital pouch has two openings. These two openings open into two different compartments. The anterior compartment and the posterior compartment. The anterior compartment is genital chamber. And the posterior compartment is vestibulum or uthecal chamber. Fine. Uthecal chamber meaning it will have uthecas. Utheca related to egg, ova. So now if this is the uthecal chamber, this opening, above this opening, what will be there? There will be vagina. So vagina directly opens into this uthecal chamber. Clear? What about the genital chamber? What will collect in that genital chamber? The genital chamber is having the opening of spermatheca. Spermatheca is the place where sperms will be stored. Sperms kahan se aayenge? Obviously after copulation. Clear? How will it come? I'll tell you in a process. Clear with this? Is this part clear, everyone? Any question? Yes, Saloni, vestibulum plus genital chamber is genital pouch. Am I clear with this? This is very important part, students. Okay, so is this is about genital pouch. If you all have not understood, again, I'm explaining as a diagrammatic representation. Imagine this is the roof of genital chamber, genital pouch. It will have two openings. There is an anterior and posterior opening, right? Anterior opening hai, so uske niche ek pouch hoga, there will be a chamber opening hai, so there has to be something. This is what? The anterior pouch, which is known as genital chamber. What is opening into this genital chamber? It is the spermatheca. So this is spermatheca. Fine. What about posterior opening? The posterior opening is nothing but vaginal opening. So this is opening into the pouch below. I'll draw it in dotted way because it is behind. That is known as utheca chamber. So diagrammatic and by experiment. Is it clear? Have you all understood or not? Okay, now I guess you all can understand the diagram again, which was here. See this. Clear? Genital chamber is and vestibulum together is the genital pouch. See here, the genital chamber and pouch dotted banaya. Right? Along with that, around this genital pouch, there are collateral glands also. So there are collateral glands which are seen. And there are gonapophyses. What are gonapophyses? The gonapophyses are the external genital ear. Yes, done with this. Any question? Okay. Okay, great. Now let's go to the copulation part of the two. How is the copulation taking place? This is the copulation. Again, the process, pay attention, I'll go point by point. Copulation meaning sexual intercourse. The first difference when we talk about humans and cockroaches, copulation is from the posterior end. What is the meaning of it? In cockroach, the two cockroach, that is the male and female, come together in this way. They form 180 degrees. Fine, this is the head part, the anal part. The anal part and the head part. So head is facing that side, the two anal part are coming closer. Theek hai? Why? What is the reason? Because there are gonapophyses here. Am I clear? So the first is the two cockroaches come together in such a way that the anal part of male and female are closer to each other. They are fusing or they are coming in contact. Next thing, we saw that males have phallomeres. So come on, let's draw a representation here. This is the male cockroach. Okay, these are the phallomeres, that is the extension sort of structures. And this is the female part. The female part, this is the extension. Okay? You all remember I told you all in abdomen part, pay attention. The 10th terja in the both male and female is curved like that, going behind. Yes? So that means this part is little detachable, you can say. Okay? Now what happens? See this. This is the 10th terja, which is backwards in female. This is the phallomere of the male. This phallomere tries to slightly separate this terja. Why? Definitely for penetration. Clear? So this phallomere is trying to separate this and try to penetrate. Okay, once it is penetrating, the sperms are already ready in the male part in the form of spermatophore. So these are the spermatophores which are there. The spermatophore, inside it there are sperms, tries to penetrate the female body from the anal part. Okay, when it is trying to enter, obviously the spermatophores are very big, hard, they just attach this way. The spermatophores are not able to enter because it is a big structure. They just attach to this part of the female. Male cockroach, the work is done, gone. Now what will happen? The moment this starts attaching, the spermatophore starts breaking up, okay, and releases sperms inside the female body. Where will that sperms go? It will go in the spermathecas. So spermatheca is storing sperms, not spermatophore. Only sperms will enter. After some time, once the sperms are gone, these spermatophores will fall off. Clear? Now we have the genital pouch, in that the genital chamber is filled with sperms. Right? Now at the same time, the oothecas, this is the vagina, the oothecas are released in the oothecal chamber. Right? The oothecal chambers here. So, yahan pe sperms aa gaye and there are ootheca also coming. In this genital chamber, the sperms are already present, and vestibulum, that is the ootheca, has the ovas or the eggs. Both will fuse. That is, fertilization takes place in the genital pouch. Theek hai? Entry is different, but they fuse in the pouch. Once they fuse, the fertilized egg will be formed or zygote. Jaise hi that egg is formed, suppose this is the egg. This is the egg which is formed. The collateral glands will secrete a substance so that layer is formed around this ootheca, that is known as oothecal membrane. So your fertilized egg is properly protected because of secretion by collateral glands. Theek hai? Once this ootheca membrane with the fertilized egg is ready, these oothecal will be attached here, the same way as spermatophores were attached. Now this female cockroach wants to deposit this ootheca, because then only the baby cockroaches will come out. So what is this cockroach doing? It will go in darker areas, ek deposit kar degi. Area, second deposit, third deposit, fourth, and so on. This is how her job is done. Fine. Now the best part is, or you can say the surprising part is, see here. One ootheca. What is ootheca? The membrane by collateral gland. It does not have just one fertilized egg. No. One ootheca has 14 to 16 fertilized eggs. So this is one ootheca. There are 16 such fertilized eggs inside, arranged in two rows. And at one time, such ootheca are 9 to 10 in number. Ek ootheca mein 16 eggs hai and there are 10 such ootheca. So what will be the total number of fertilized eggs? 160. That means one female cockroach at one time delivers 160 eggs. 160 eggs will develop into 160 cockroaches. Clear? That is how the population of cockroaches is increasing. Okay? This is about the process. Am I clear? Is this explanation in the flowchart form easier? Along with the diagram and the explanation. Come on. Speak up, students. Perfect, Vaibhav. ओके अमित नेवनाथ परफेक्ट गुड आफ्टरनून करण परफेक्ट सलोनी थैंक यू परफेक्ट परफेक्ट ग्रेट चलो सो दिस इज अबाउट कॉकरोच रिप्रोडक्शन Now let's start with some other systems. I hope you all have taken the screenshot. Now it's all easier part. There are some students who are saying that this is not an NCERT. I guess you all have not seen the diagrams in the NCERT properly then. If the diagrams are mentioned and if the parts are labeled, they can ask any question related to it. And it is not a very difficult part. Next, let's go to the nervous system. Now these are all very easy parts. When I talk about the nervous system of the cockroach, there are two things related to it. One is ganglia and other is longitudinal connectives. Two things are there. If you all remember when we were doing Animal Kingdom, it is already mentioned that the nerve cord is ventral in them, right? And in us it is dorsal. So entire nervous system is on the ventral side. Theek hai? Very easy to remember. I have given very easy points here. So how will I explain this? I'll just explain and then you can see the diagram. There will be the main ganglia. This is known as supraesophageal ganglia. This is present in the head region of the cockroach. Then there is a small ganglia which is subesophageal, that is below in the thorax region. These two are connected by longitudinal connectives. From this arises the main ventral nerve cord. Okay, when this nerve cord is passing, this is the entire body of the cockroach. This nerve cord also shows some ganglia in the entire body. These ganglia are nothing but collection of small nerves. These are total 10 in number. Out of that, three are in thorax and the remaining are in abdomen. It is not 10, it is 9, I'm sorry. The three are in thorax and six are in abdomen. Clear? From each ganglia, the nerves arise and they supply the areas. Done. This much only. Okay, so there is a supraesophageal ganglia, the main part. There is a subesophageal ganglia. Both are connected by these connectives, which is again made up of nerves. From that arises the ventral nerve cord. That ventral nerve cord has lot many ganglia in the entire body. These ganglia are smaller as compared to these two. And each ganglia arises the nerve fibers which is supplying the entire body. The total ganglia are 9 in number. These are the small ones. Out of that, 3 are in thorax, 6 are in abdomen. Okay? The main one, that is the supraesophageal, acts like the brain. So there is no separate brain. It is only the ganglia which is acting like brain. Clear with this? Now I guess you all can see this diagram and take a screenshot. Question in nervous system. Let me know. Yes, any doubt, any question? Saloni, Induvadam, Vaibhav. Okay. Great, Vaibhav, great. Yes, Saloni, if that's why the head of the cockroach is cut, nothing will happen to it at least for some days. The reason is because if the brain is gone, even there is one more ganglia to take over for some time. So even after some days, the cockroach will die because of no nutrition in the body, not because of brain absent. Clear? Yes, Saloni, you are right. Fine? Okay, chalo. Let's go to the next system. I hope you all have taken the screenshot. The next is what we are talking about is the digestive system. So the section is taken and this is the digestive. So they have removed the digestive outside the body. Okay. So there are three parts of the digestive system. You have the foregut, the midgut and the hindgut. Okay. Foregut is something which is the beginning part, or you can say attached with the mouth. This is the foregut, made up of mouth. The mouth part, I hope you all remember the mouth parts: labium, labrum, mandible, maxilla, hypopharynx. Then there is this small esophagus. Then there is this bigger part which is the crop. And there is this gizzard. All these together forms the foregut. Clear? So there is mouth, esophagus, crop and gizzard. Okay? After this, the next is the midgut. Midgut does not have separate parts, it is just midgut. And the third part is the hindgut. This is the hindgut, which has ileum, colon and rectum. No jejunum and duodenum are seen, only ileum. Fine. These are the main parts of digestive system: foregut, midgut, hindgut. Okay. Now what we have to see, we have to understand, which is a very important question. It is given in your NCERT also. So just a very important part is this. Foregut is the first part. Then you have the midgut. And at the end you have the hindgut. Between foregut and midgut, here you can see some extensions coming out. These are known as hepatic cecae. Okay. Between mid and hind gut, there are malpighian tubules. What is malpighian tubule doing? Excretion. Malpighian tubule is doing excretion and it is present here in digestive. That means cockroaches, in the name of excretion system, have only one organ. Fine. And empty, that is malpighian tubule, is related, or you can say connected, to digestive. That means malpighian tubule does not have its own process. It is somewhere related to the digestive. How? I'll come to it. Clear? So are the parts of the main digestive system clear? Any question here in this? No, dear. Malpighian tubule is between the midgut and the hindgut. Yes, students, any doubt, please post your doubts. Saloni, am I clear with this? Perfect. Super. Okay? Now, what all things do we understand about the foregut? Foregut will have mouth, then there will be esophagus, normal hair. Now this is the important part, that is the crop. Crop is something which is the largest part of the digestive system, or the largest part of the foregut. What is the importance of this? It stores food. Okay, little bit digestion can be expected there, not major. So where is the digestion or grinding taking place? The grinding is taking place here in the gizzard. Why is it taking place in the gizzard? Because in cockroach, gizzard has teeth. So that means in cockroaches, stomach ke andar daant hai. The teeth are present inside the stomach. Clear? Which brings about grinding. Fine? Next, you have the hepatic cecki, the midgut and all. That is the normal part. How the digestion takes place? I'll come to it. This is about the major structures. Any question? Okay. Now, let's go to the next part. So this is, I've given something about the foregut, which you all have to remember. This is what I explained. Mouth is at the basis, crop, which is the largest part. Food is stored here, gizzard is there. And yes, one more important thing, gizzard is also known as proventriculus. Clear? Next, please take a screenshot of this. Now let's go to the process of digestion. Do you all remember how the food ingestion took place? In the mouth part, I had explained how the ingestion of food is taking place. What are the structures which help in taking the food and putting it inside? Anyone, come on. What was that part? Which are the two parts which was helping in catching the prey? Come on. No one remembers. Yesterday only we thought. It is the maxillary and the labial palp. Perfect. So the palp was taking the food and putting it in the mouth, then hypopharynx was releasing the saliva, right? So after the ingestion, the food from the mouth enters the esophagus and then the crop. So this is the mouth, the esophagus and the crop. So it enters the crop. After crop, it enters the gizzard. In the gizzard, the grinding takes place. And then it enters the midgut. So here, then it enters the midgut. Once it enters the midgut, what are these? These are the hepatic cecki, which also secretes some secretion, which helps the food to get digested. Now there is this important and unique thing happening in the midgut. Very important. As the food enters the midgut, the wall of midgut secretes peritrophic membrane. This wall starts secreting a peritrophic membrane. Same way the way it was in spermatophore. Sperms ke around there was a membrane. Similarly, here also the small particles of food is covered by a peritrophic membrane which is secreted by midgut. What is the importance of this peritrophic membrane? Now here the grinding is taking place, but cockroach eats anything, stones and all. So it might happen the small pieces of stones can rupture the midgut wall. So just to protect it, this peritrophic membrane is covering. But this peritrophic membrane is also allowing enzymes to enter and go out, and even the food particles can come and go out. That is, you know, you can say very much crushed food particles. So that is happening in this midgut. Then the midgut will secrete certain enzymes, normal enzyme the way it is in us, invertase, maltase, lactase, trypsin, proper digestion will take place. Then this enter the hindgut. ileum will absorb a little bit and the waste is out of the body. This is how digestion takes place. Any question? Is the digestion part clear, everyone? Hello, Arun. Hi. I hope you are understanding. Perfect, Induvanam. Perfect, perfect. Done? Any questions? So please take a screenshot of this, and with this we complete the digestive. Is it not easier, students? Is there anything so big? Are cockroach hai, cockroach hai. What? Cockroach hi to hai. And I hope the flowcharts will help you all, or the pointers will help you all. Yes, Adon and Samuel. Samuel Mathai, any doubt? No, ma'am, is for what? You have not understood? No ma'am, kyun bola hai? Or have you all understood? If there is no doubt, uska answer no ma'am hai? Yeah, you have understood, uska answer no ma'am hai. What is it, Samuel? Perfect, good. Great. So with this, we complete the digestion also. This is also what I was explaining. So you all can take the screenshot. Now let's go to the excretion. If you all can see the heading, excretion likha hai maine. I have not written excretory system because there is no separate excretory system present. The excretion is done with the help of MT, that is malpighian tubule, fat body, nephrocytes and uricose gland. I hope you all remember uricose gland. Uricose glands are in males related to mushroom gland. Fat bodies are the structures which are present inside the abdomen where the ovaries and testes were embedded. Nephrocytes are normal cells present all over the body. So all these four structures are doing excretion, removing the nitrogenous waste, but not connected with each other. They work independently. The main organ here is malpighian tubule. Where is this malpighian tubule? At the junction of midgut and hindgut. How does malpighian tubule works? See this. First, let's see the diagram, then you all can see the flowchart. Imagine, this is the midgut. Okay, a section of it. And what is this? This is the hindgut. Okay? At the junction of midgut and hindgut, there are these malpighian tubules. These are malpighian tubules. These malpighian tubules are fine tubules ending directly in the body. So it is somewhat embedded in the body. Okay? This is about it. Now, what is this malpighian tubule doing? The first thing is, this malpighian tubule starts extracting nitrogenous waste from the body. It is collecting this waste from the body. This waste is in the form of potassium, sodium, urate, water, carbon dioxide, everything. Okay, from the body, directly the nitrogenous waste is entering the malpighian tubule. Inside the malpighian tubule, all these structures or all these substances react with each other. And as a result, bicarbonates and uric acid are formed. So number one step, the nitrogenous waste are collected, they react with each other and bicarbonates and uric acid are formed. So this is bicarbonate, uric acid. Clear? Now what happens? The wall of the malpighian tubule is permeable to bicarbonates. So, if suppose these colored ones are bicarbonates, just for you all to understand. The wall removes this bicarbonate outside. Outside matlab in the body. Why? Because bicarbonates are salts which our body requires. And apart from that, if there are certain water also, that is again absorbed in the body. We don't want bicarbonates and water to go out. Clear? So if water is out, bicarbonate is out, what is left in the malpighian tubule is only and only uric acid. As the water is coming out, the uric acid is now getting precipitated. If you all remember, if you all have done excretion chapter in your 11th standard, you all know one thing. Uric acid does not require water for its removal. Right? Because it precipitates easily. So here also the same thing happens. The uric acid precipitates. And as it is precipitating, it is coming inside or towards the center. Fine, because this is like a flow happening. Transport of water, you all must have studied. So the uric acid finally enters the hindgut. What is more entering in the hindgut? The undigested waste is also entering from midgut. So this hindgut excretes two things, undigested waste and nitrogenous waste together. So that means in cockroaches, I cannot say egestion, not ingestion. Egestion and excretion are separate. It is mixture. Or in other words, I cannot say that cockroach is urinating or it is a removal of fecal matter. It is together. In fact, urine is not a liquid in cockroach. Why? Because water is gone and uric acid is precipitated. Clear? This is how excretion and digestion are linked. Fine. But this wasn't a good thing. For cockroach, it was okay because that much of metabolism is not there. The problem with this process is that nitrogenous waste removal is very less. And hence, as the time passed, evolution was needed. Thus, after non-caudates, in the caudates, there is a separate excretory system which is seen. Okay, which is more effective and essential for the body. Am I clear with this excretion part? Perfect, perfect. What about others? Come on, message. Perfect, Vaibhav. Perfect. So come on, take a screenshot also. Take a screenshot of this process. Next is the last part, that is the respiratory system of the cockroach. Now, if you'll remember, when we were talking about animal kingdom, in that when we spoke about arthropoda, okay, I had told you all that in arthropoda, there is open circulation seen. Why? But still it is more evolved than annelid. Because in arthropoda, the respiratory system is so well developed that you don't require blood or circulation to help in respiration. Right? That is the beauty of arthropoda. And in that arthropoda also, class insecta is highly evolved because it shows a well developed tracheal system. What is this tracheal system? This is the body. This is the body of the cockroach. On the sides, you see small, small openings. These openings are known as spiracles. What is the purpose of these openings? To take the air directly. That is oxygen. In us, the oxygen enters via blood. Here, the oxygen is entering directly. So, I can say that cockroaches have many nose all around the body. These are known as spiracles. Okay, these spiracles are playing the major role in respiration. These are the spiracles. Each spiracle is then connected to series of tubules known as tracheae. And all these trachea are also interconnected. Thus, entire body gets gases easily. If you can see this, it looks like a big network. See these. These are the spiracles. These are the tracheas connected here, connected here, connected here, everywhere. Understood? This is the respiratory system. Now let's see one spiracle, how is it doing respiration? Similarly, all the spiracles will do the respiration. This is the main diagram, what you all have to remember. This is one spiracle and the extension of it. Okay? What all things do you see here? Now total number of spiracles are 10 pairs in the entire body. This is what I was talking about when I got confused with the ganglia. First two pairs are in thorax and the remaining eight are in abdomen. This is one spiracle which I am showing here. Okay? So see here, what is this spiracle? This is an opening. This opening continues into a chamber. This is known as atrium. This atrium has certain structures, hair-like structures, so that if the dust is entering, it will throw out the dust. Similarly, the hairs which are there in our nose. This will then continue as a tube which is known as trachea. This trachea is covered by a layer known as cuticle. Cuticle prevents it from collapsing. This trachea then opens into many tubules. These are known as tracheoles. These tracheoles directly open into tissue fluid. That means it is directly embedded in the body. Fine? No cuticle is seen in tracheole. So one question which is very important, tracheae and tracheoles. What all things we have to remember? A question can be asked. Tracheae has cuticle, no cuticle here. Okay? Tracheae does not have any fluid inside it, but the tracheoles has fluid inside it. That is known as basically tissue fluid. Now you all will understand why tracheoles do not have cuticle. What is tissue fluid? Tissue fluid is everywhere. Okay? This tissue fluid is entering and coming out in the tracheoles. This is possible only why? Because there is no cuticle around it. If there was cuticle, tissue fluid ka entry exit wouldn't have been possible. Clear? This is the main difference between the two. Am I clear with this? Any question here? Okay, Saloni, that's okay. Don't worry. Yes, is this part clear, everyone? Okay, so how does the respiration take place? So that is the process, the last part for today. This tire is surrounded by muscles. So there are the tergite, sternite muscles everywhere, right? These muscles contract and relax continuously. When the muscles are relaxing, the spiracles are bigger. When the spiracles are bigger, what will happen? Oxygen gas gets in. Then the spiracles are contracting, relaxing little bit. Oxygen gas passes ahead, passes more ahead, comes here. Once it enters the tracheole, the tissue fluid gets carbon dioxide from the entire body because of high to low. Oxygen is high inside, so oxygen will go out. Carbon dioxide is high outside, so carbon dioxide will come in. By the time the carbon dioxide is coming in, this part, the tracheole, will show a little bit of peristalsis, so carbon dioxide is move ahead and it is out. This is how respiration takes place. Easy? So the muscles responsible here were turgosternite muscle, that is tergum and sternite related. Am I clear with this? Take a screenshot of this and take a screenshot of this also. This one. Done? Yes, students. Come on, come on. Saloni, Vaibhav, Induvanam, Shruti, Vaibhav. Come on, come on. Yes or no? Perfect, Shruti, Vaibhav, great. So I hope you all are clear with this cockroach. Right, start solving the question. If there is anything, let me know in the next lecture. Yes, there is one thing I wanted to show you all before I wind up. So now we will meet in the new year. Right, so happy new year, happy 2021. And I hope that this 2021 brings great news for all the budding doctors. So meet you all in the next year. Stay safe and study well. Theek hai? Chalo, bye-bye everyone. Take care.